Hello, everybody. My name is Budley Neck, and today we're going to be taking a look at Alex's Mobs. The version I'm going over is for Forge 116.4, and it currently adds 18 amazingly well-thought-out and designed mobs. During this video, I'm going to be using a lot of different shaders, and I'll put the name of the shader down in the bottom right at the beginning of each clip. And I'll put the name of the mob and where you can find it in the top right. And I think that's all you need to know. Let's get started. The first mob we're going to take a look at is the grizzly bear. These omnivores can be found in forest biomes and will often have a couple of cubs following them around. While neutral at a distance, these guys will get hostile if you get too close. Grizzlies will tear into beehives filled with honey and feast on their honeycomb. If you feed it salmon immediately after, you can tame the bear and use it as a mount. Whether you're on or off the bear, he'll make short work of any enemies that you come across. Occasionally, grizzlies will shed some of their hair. And if brewed with potions of strength, it will create potions of knockback resistance. Next up, we have the Roadrunner. You can find these birds zipping through deserts and badlands. They can be bred with maggots, which you can get from flies. More on that later. Given the opportunity, these birds will attack any rattlesnakes that cross their path. Roadrunners are sought after for their feathers, which can be used to craft Roadrunner boots, which give a huge speed boost when on sand. Skipping rattlesnakes for now, the Komodo dragon is the largest lizard in the world and can be found in Badlands biomes. These will attack man or beast, and even other weakened Komodo dragons, especially baby ones. They have an extremely poisonous bite and can occasionally drip their noxious saliva that you can use to make slime balls, or you can bottle it to use in other recipes. These guys love rotten flesh and will eat stacks of it. If you feed them enough, it will eventually become tame to you and can be used as a surprisingly fast mount. Moving on to the cave centipede. This is a rare subterranean arthropod that's hostile and can be found deep in caves. Although slow, centipedes can deal large amounts of damage and they have a poisonous bite. They can drop their legs, which can be crafted into pants that allow you to climb walls, or brewed with bottles of Komodo dragon spit to make poisonous essence. And now that we have the poisonous essence, let's go back to the rattlesnake. This dangerous reptile can be found in deserts and badlands and will rattle its tail to give warning to any creatures within range. If one gets too close while it's rattling, it will turn hostile and attack with its poisonous bite. The rattlesnake can drop its rattle that you can then brew with poisonous essence to get potions of poison resistance. The gazelle can be found in large herds grazing in savanna biomes. These are timid creatures, and if one is attacked, the rest of the herd will flee in fear. Gazelle can drop mutton, and occasionally their horns, which you can brew with a speed 2 potion to upgrade it to speed 3. The crocodile is a massive, hostile reptile that rarely spawns in rivers and swamps. It will lunge at its prey, grabbing and pulling it back into the water, where it will perform a devastating death roll. The crocodile will come ashore during the day to bask in the sunlight. At this time, it can lay eggs. You can throw these eggs like chicken eggs with a chance at spawning a baby croc. This baby will imprint on the closest being and will defend its area of birth from monsters. Crocodiles will drop scutes on becoming an adult and on death. You can use these scutes to craft a crocodile chest plate that gives increased swim speed. Staying in the water, let's move to the hammerhead shark. They can be found in warm waters and will target any creatures below half health. They also seek out tropical fish and squid. Occasionally, when attacking their prey, they'll lose one of their many teeth. You can use these teeth to create arrows that travel better underwater and do extra damage to aquatic creatures. Orca can be seen bobbing up and down out of the water in cold climates. They often launch attacks on the native salmon and polar bear populations. And if you hurt an orca, the entire pod will come to its defense. Finishing up the water creatures is the lobster. These small crustaceans enjoy beach biomes and will defend themselves with a pinch. Usually, most lobsters that you find are going to be red, but there are rare occasions of other colors. When slain, lobsters can drop lobster tail that can be cooked up for a delicious meal. And you can bucket lobsters to collect them, just like you currently do fish. Hummingbirds can be found in jungles, flower forests, and sunflower biomes. You can comb and breed them with flowers, and these are the best pollinators in the game. Even better than bees. Capuchin monkeys are native to jungles, and you can tame them with bananas. You can get bananas by breaking jungle leaves. These are some of the most sophisticated pets in the game. You can set them to stay, follow, wander, or you can have them right on your shoulder. These guys have both ranged and melee attacks, and if you have one on your shoulder, he'll throw rocks at your targets. You can heal your monkeys by feeding them eggs, and you can breed them by feeding them maggots. You can also find gorillas in jungles. These peaceful protectors like to socialize and are likely to be found in groups. While peaceful at heart, if gorillas are provoked, they can deal out massive amounts of damage. Each group is led by a silverback who's 2 to 3 times stronger than any other gorilla, and can often be seen pounding their chest when anxious. Gorillas can become more trustful and friendly if given bananas, and if you give them enough, they can be commanded to sit or wander, and they'll automatically come to your defense in times of need. The sunbird is a mythical crane that can be found soaring above the tallest mountains. Being incarnations of flame themselves, these birds are immune to all flame, heat, and lava damage. They can grant their blessing on any player that gets within reach that makes it easier to fly with an elytra. This is pretty much the dolphin's grace of the sky. And if attacked, they'll apply a curse to the attacker that makes them fall to the ground, usually to their demise. Sunbirds are holy creatures, and they cause the undead to ignite in flames when nearby, just as if they were under the sun. The last creature of the overworld is the lowly fly. These small, annoying insects are a common nuisance to the overworld and are attracted to dead or dying things, like zombies. They can be bred using rotten flesh, and you can get maggots from them when they die. And finally, if a fly finds its way into the nether, it will transform into a crimson mosquito. Crimson mosquitoes are hideous mutant flying insects found in crimson forests. They'll seek out and fill up on the blood of any warm-blooded animal. Once they've had their fill, they'll fly up and start spitting the blood back at their prey. If you kill the crimson mosquito when it's inflated with blood, it can drop its blood sac. And it can drop its proboscis anytime. Both of these items are required to craft a blood sprayer, which is a unique weapon that deals AoE damage and uses blood sacs as ammo. And in the deep lava lakes of the Nether, you can find the bone serpent. This giant creature is hostile to players and wither skeletons. When it targets a creature, it will leap out of the lava and attempt to crush it underneath it. And when defeated, bone serpents explode into piles of bones and have a chance to drop one of their teeth. You can brew this tooth with bottles of lava to get potions of lava vision. These allow you to see in lava as if it were water. Here's the effect with Sora shaders on, and here's the effect with no shaders. As you can see, that is a pretty drastic improvement, and this is what it looks like with no shaders under lava. And last, but definitely not least, is the Endergrade. This is the long-lost cousin of the microscopic Tardigrade. Due to a lack of predators, these creatures have become gigantic. You can find them floating around in chorus forests. They can be lured and bred using chorus fruit, and you can saddle and ride them using a chorus fruit on a stick. While these guys are slow, they're extremely useful to reach hard-to-get places and to avoid falling into the void. And that covers all the current mobs. I want to take a minute and thank the developers of this mod real quick. They've obviously put a lot of hard work, hours, and love into this mod, and I just wanted to let them know that we do appreciate it. I love how all the mobs come together and interact with each other and with vanilla mobs to form an entirely new ecosystem. I want to give a really big thank you to my Patreon supporters. Thank you guys so much. Their names are on the screen right now. I'd also like to thank you for watching and for sticking around to the very end. I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, you know what to do. Hit that like button down below. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Keep playing. Keep having fun. We will see you guys next time.